here's a tutorial on how to use Office for Mac, Excel 2008, and let's open up some data here. You can get this if you go to the Styles Guide page. Let me zoom in and make it a little bit larger, stretch this out. And you can see we've got data here for photosynthesis. We've got five trials, which means we did this experiment five times. We've got five results for one type of plant, Elodia, and Elodia is an aquatic plant. And we've also got numbers for geranium. Again, five trials, five different volumes of oxygen measured in mils per hour for these two different plants. What we want to do is find the average and standard deviation for these. I'll take those two pieces of information and make a graph in another video, but this is going to get you started to show you how to use formulas. There's different ways to get formulas. One way is to click in the box called a cell where you want that information to go, and we want to make an average of all these five numbers that I'm just highlighting there. So click in the average one, and let's put a formula in there. This FX is short for formula. It opens the formula builder, and I'm going to click on that. And we want to put in average. So I'm going to click at the top, pretending I can't see average there. So let's just click up here and type average and type enter. And we'll have a list of all those different formulas. So here we can see average there. I'm going to double click it to get it in there. And it's already selected 1 to 5 for Elodia. You can see that in the blue box. So let's accept that. I'm going to hit enter. And there's my average, 4.1. If I want to copy that formula under geranium, you can see there's a little box in the corner here. I can grab that little box. It turns my cursor from a big white plus sign to a little black plus sign. And if I pull it over, it'll copy it over. But it's using these data up here instead. Okay, so that's the first one. Let's put for standard deviation, the standard deviation formula. And this is it, Stdev. But let's pretend we don't know that. So if we click on here and type standard deviation, it'll tell us, you know, what kinds of formulas we have. And you can see not all these say standard deviation. So again, click up here, and looking under the description, it'll say it estimates the standard deviation based on a sample. So that's pretty much what we're looking for. So let's accept that. I'm going to double click it. And notice that it selected everything, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, but it also selected the average. That's not what we're looking for. So I'm going to click on the top number and drag it down just to include those numbers we want. And hit enter, and there's the standard deviation for this particular plant. So I could grab the little plus sign and move that over, but let's try something different. Let me close the formula builder and show you another trick. If I want a standard deviation here, and we already know that the formula is STDEV, we saw that by looking it up. If you memorize that, you can just go click in that cell. Oops, let me hit escape. I want to click into the cell here, put in a new formula. I'm going to put in an equal sign. I'm going to type STDEV, which is the formula, and an open parenthesis. I'm going to paint just the five values. I'm going to avoid the average, and then I'm going to close the parenthesis, though I think if you just hit enter, it'll still work. And there we have it. We've got the average, and just for fun, I'll change the color. I'll make it yellow. Average for Elodia and geranium, and these are the numbers we want to plot in a graph. And we've also got the standard deviation, which tells us how much it varies over the mean. So I'm going to make them colors just because it's pretty that way. And we're going to use those values in another presentation that I'm going to do.